I am trying to get in touch with 125 Institute of Technology, Hisar. Sir, you please identify yourself and tell me something about your center.
I am Dr. Sanjay Singla from center code 1258. 1258 Om Institute of Technology and Management, Hisar, Haryana. This workshop is very good, and the program at the Vigyan Bhavan in Delhi is very good. You have telecast very good, and the tablet that I have received from IIT Bombay, that is I have bring with me, that is two tablet, and performance of tablet is very good. We have also successfully conducted the quiz on the tablet. This is a very good product for the students as well as teacher also. We will try to make some R&D on these tablets so that it can be benefit to us as well as to the nation also.
Do you have only those two tablets with you, or have you received some more from CDAC Noida? Over.
We have not received more tablets, but we have received only two that I have bring with, from IIT Bombay.
So it's only a question of time before you receive them. Thank you. Over and out. 1284 Saroj Mohan Institute, West Bengal. Over to you.
Hello sir, I have some question on some assignment, on group assignment. We already form group of three, minimum three and maximum five members. The question is that what type of assignment we should choose? Can you give some idea what will be the topic or what will be the assignment?
Okay, I am told by Professor Fatak that the details work, detailed working of the assignment, he will put up instructions on Moodle within a day or so. Meanwhile, the assignment has to do something with the Aakash or Android tablets. So, something to do with the software which is already on Aakash, use of that software, or some other software which is Android compatible, you try to implement it on Aakash. Or try to use Aakash and the Aakash software for any educational purpose in your college.
It is based on some topic, on some subject, right? That when we choose one topic from any subject.
Yes.
And then we have the, they are preparing some assignment using the tablet.
Yes, that is what you can do. For example, now that you know that you can conduct quizzes, maybe some quick clicker quizzes based on some topics and subtopics you could come up with. Or if you have some videos which are either open source or available on the net, or some videos which you have created, you can use the proximity tool to provide the interactive functionality of that.
Mr. Can you, sir, give us some example of assignment?
These examples will be made available by Professor Fatak in a day, in his note which he will be putting up on Moodle. All these things would have been ready today, except that Professor Fatak had to leave yesterday evening for Delhi for that big meeting today morning in Delhi. That's why it got delayed by a day. In fact, Professor Fatak wanted to address you today afternoon, but I am told he is already at the airport in Delhi on his way to Dubai, so he won't be able to get in touch with you. At least he won't be able to get in touch with you just now. Tomorrow through Moodle will definitely be possible. Over. 1207 Jawaharlal Institute of Technology, Borawa, Madhya Pradesh.
Sir, I am Sanjay Chauhan from Jawaharlal Institute of Technology, center code 1207. First of all, thank you very much, sir, for organizing such a nice and wonderful workshop for us. Secondly, I have one query. At the time of quiz submission via clicker, the timer is fluctuating many times. Sir, second question is about assignment. Assignment question is related with the Aakash project or it is related with the some application?
Okay, the first question was when the clicker quiz was going on, the timing was fluctuating. Perhaps the reason for this is a communication issue or the bandwidth problem. Because the quiz was conducted centrally from this place, all the control was here. So actually the clock was running on our server here and the image was being transmitted to you. Now if it takes 3 seconds for the image to be transmitted, your clock will be 3 seconds slow. But suddenly you get a good time and the delay is only 1 second, you will find in 1 second your clock has gone fast by 3 seconds. But I think on an average, the 4 minute time given to you was maybe 4 minutes plus or minus a few seconds. Okay. The second thing is about assignment. As I have already said, the assignment had something to do with Aakash, the software and on Aakash, either use of the current software on Aakash, or because it's open source, you can study the source and try to modify a part of it, or study the applications on Aakash, study their source and create similar or enhanced or other appropriate applications of Aakash. By Aakash, I mean typically an Android tablet, so something which works on a generic Android tablet, create it and try to implement it on Aakash. Aakash may not exactly be like a generic Android tablet, but it will be similar. With some effort, you should be able to port it to Aakash. There is another set of projects you can do. See, Aakash is a low cost tablet, and hence the capabilities of Aakash, the hardware specifications of Aakash are not very jazzy. So programs and applications and software suites which are written for a laptop necessarily or usually assume that you will have a processor, maybe dual core or a quad core processor with a few gigahertz, a huge cache, a huge main memory, fast writing and reading from a hard disk. Such facilities are just not available in Aakash. So in that restricted environment, whatever best you can do of your software, that itself is a good assignment. Okay. For example, you have a C compiler, C++ compiler, but somebody wants a, you know, implement some part of Java on it, try implementing it. Today morning it was informed to you that Flash is not yet implemented on Aakash. I don't know whether it is worth implementing Flash, but somebody could try. Java is not yet ported onto Aakash. If it is worth porting it, one could try. And you know, many attempts together will finally result in some good things coming out of it. Some 3, 4, 5 people in 10 to 15 days, well, they will take a few steps, but they may not be able to reach the final goal. I think that takes care of your questions. Over and out. Let me go to some other center now. I have latched on to 1153 Tejpur University.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, myself Pradyumna Kumar Choudhury from Energy Department. I would like to know one about added features in Aakash. Sir, here I have seen in the King's Office software at inbuilt here, can read documents from Microsoft Office as well as spreadsheets as well as blank presentation PPT files. But is it possible, sir, to use this Aakash for reading Access database, or can I make some copy from our computer to this Aakash Access database, or will it be working here? Sir, over to you, sir.
Yes, since you want to access the database which is on other PC, so similar thing what we are also doing it here for the clicker is the same thing. The results are generated and displayed on your clicker is from the database which is there in IIT Bombay. Okay, so definitely you can use, make it as a web server or make some application which is communicating with your tablet and just sending the data.
Sir, in that case, can I use my laptop as a server of the database and using the Aakash?
Yes, you can definitely use it.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
1225 BMS College of Engineering, Bangalore, Karnataka. Over to you.
Sir, like I would like to first ask about Aakash specifications, like because it is pretty low end actually. So how effective can be the tablet in teaching aid? Battery backup is very low actually. It doesn't come even for about half an hour.
Hello. Yeah, you have to charge the battery for the first time fully, at least for once. We have tested several tablets here in IIT Bombay, and we have found the battery lasting for almost around 2 to 3 hours. We have tested it almost around 150 tablets out here in IIT Bombay. So on an average, the time what we have got it is from 2 to 3 hours. That too in continuous video playing. Over to you.
So on that end, I would like to argue we have charged actually for 8 hours, sir. But we haven't got backup for about even about 45 minutes, I think. I contend that particular this thing. It is not coming for even 45 minutes.
Is it with only one piece or something like that, or all the tablets whatever you have received are having the same issues?
Yeah, most of the tablets actually. It is generally for most of the tablets.
So I just request you once more time, ki first charge it the tablet full 100% at least once. Then we can see it.
Coming back to the specifications, 512 MB, how effective can be the thing? I mean, how fast it can be?
See, Aakash tablet is an access device, low cost access device to watch few educational videos, few to surf the net and get the information, not for computing. So it's an access device, as the name is.
But still again, nowadays at least 1 hour or 2 GBs would be even there in a simplest gadgets. So why have you gone for 512?
See, one can always talk about 2 GBs or 4 GBs or whatever it is. Remember that one of the major constraints on the Aakash specification was that the whole thing should be available in less than 2500 rupees. That's why we, since Aakash 1 was negotiated at something like 2279 rupees, we got as near or better specifications for almost the same cost. That 15-16 rupees is a minor issue, but that low cost is the main thing. The access cum computation, in access cum computation, access is the main thing. Some minor computation capabilities are made available on Aakash. And that's why I think we said yesterday very clearly that although C, C++ compilers are available, they are to be used for maybe small programs which a student at the learning stage writes down, maybe a screenful or two screenful. You just don't expect it to, I mean, it will compile a 3000 line C program for all you know, but then it will take much more time. If you have to compile and debug and run 3000 line C or C++ programs, well, Aakash is not the device. It's not a computer. It's a mainly an access device. It's a one of the thinnest of clients that you have, if you want to use the thin client terminology. But it's a client, remember. The best environment for Aakash is a few students or a few dozens of students or 100-150 students in a classroom with a Wi-Fi connectivity, which takes care through the Wi-Fi to a server, and the Aakash is an access device. Does some minimal amount of computation, but that's about it. Don't expect great things out of a 2263 rupee tablet. Over.
Now there are two projects here. One is the Aakash project. And the other one is, let me call the
The second one is, let me say, this is the Aakash 2 project, and let us say this is the NMEICT 2 project. Okay. Aakash project is about the use of A2 tablets in engineering education. Okay. And here there are Aakash project centers. All of those have been identified. Currently each one has 2 tablets, plus you will have soon 20, finally going to something like 100 plus tablets or more as the need arises. Okay. The NMEICT, here we stop with Aakash project centers, okay, which will talk to the main center at IIT Bombay. Now, NMEICT is the National Mission on Education. For us, it is essentially engineering education. And the history of this is that there was an NMEICT project. It was not called NMEICT 1 project. People called it the Ekalavya project, and the name Ekalavya is still being used. Okay. Under this, we conducted a number of workshops. I think the workshops were conducted on computer programming and utilization, then databases, then thermodynamics in mechanical engineering, then we had one on heat transfer, we had on photovoltaics, then we had on CFD, and maybe something more I might have missed. Oh, we had on research methodology, then we had a teacher's workshop, right? Writing effective papers, etc., etc. Now, this was done by IIT Bombay as the main center, and there were a number of peripheral centers. For example, I was involved in thermodynamics, so I know there were 31 centers, and the number of centers were of that order or higher. When it came to research methodology, I think it increased to something like 200 centers, right? 168 centers. And then now for Aakash projects we have, but that is the other side of the partition, Aakash project we have something like 250 centers. Okay. Now, after having successfully completed NMEICT project, Government of India has only recently approved the NMEICT 2 project. Now, it was realized that although with this model we can expose a large number of teachers to good engineering teaching and engineering education practices, the reach is not wider enough. And if the National Mission on Education extends beyond engineering education to, you know, what is called liberal education or even to school education, then we have to have a much wider reach. So in the NMEICT 2 project, along with IIT Bombay, we will have another IIT, IIT Kharagpur, which will be a co-major center. It will not just be IIT Bombay. Soon IIT Kharagpur will come up to almost the same status as that of IIT Bombay, that the status which was for IIT Bombay for the earlier Ekalavya project. Under this, in the next 3 years, that means 3 December vacations and 3 May vacations, May-June vacations, we will conduct 15 workshops. Okay. Maybe IIT Bombay will conduct 9 of them, IIT Kharagpur will conduct 6 of them, because they will have to start off from scratch, they will have to set up things. So, it could become 10 plus 5 or 8 plus 7, something like that, but we are committed to conduct 15 workshops. Now, if you look at the scale, what is required is this. Today there are, let me slightly enhance the number, maybe there are 500 engineering colleges in India. Each college will have something like at least 100 faculty members. So, you can see the number of faculty members which exist. Now, it is perhaps too much to ask at this stage that each and every college becomes a remote center. But let us say 1 in 10 colleges becomes a remote center, because it is usually found that these engineering colleges are not uniformly distributed, they are in clusters, you know, near cities or some semi-urban places where there are clusters. So, we think that perhaps 500 remote centers is a good idea, that one remote center can typically take care of 10 colleges. Of the order of 10 colleges. Now, consider that those who have taken part in the first Ekalavya project, NMAI city project, would realize that whenever we conduct a workshop, the workshop is in two phases. There is a coordinators workshop where the coordinators of the remote centers come to IIT Bombay, we discuss the details of the main workshop, there is a lecture demonstration of the contents in the main workshop. And then we conduct the main workshop a few weeks or a few months later, where things are beamed from IIT Bombay to each one of those remote centers, the way they are beamed now from IIT Bombay to those 250 remote centers. Okay. But now consider that 500 coordinators coming to IIT Bombay to take part in the coordinators workshop. This is almost impossible to do, because we can't host 500 people here. So, what is expected is the following. We will have a plan like this: IIT Bombay and IIT Kharagpur at the top. This is one level. Those 500 remote centers. Taking care of 5,000 institutes. At the other end, but this connection 500 to 102 is too sharp. So, what is planned is something like 10 nodal centers distributed all over India. So, it is possible, we are yet to work out the details, that a few of these remote centers, typically 50 of them, will latch on to one nodal center 1. Some other will latch on to some other nodal center 2, and so on. So, these 10 nodal centers will take care of approximately 50 remote centers each. And IIT Bombay or IIT Kharagpur, or parallelly, they will beam to these 10 nodal centers. So, even the coordinators workshop will be conducted in a semi-distributed way, perhaps at, may not be all 10 at a time, but a few nodal centers. Now, these nodal centers will slowly have to come up, at least in the hardware fashion, to a level where IIT Bombay is now and IIT Kharagpur will soon be. Similarly, if we have to keep on conducting such courses, we will have to have good connectivity and good audio-visual facilities at each of these 500 remote centers. So, as part of this NMEI CT2 workshop, it is possible that each one of these 500 remote centers will be supported to some extent. I think Professor Fatak mentioned something of the order of rupees 3 lakhs for creating a local LAN, local wireless hotspots, and a local audio visual system, capture and projection system, okay, as well as a good link with IITB and IIT KGP and the nodal centers. Now, since the nodal centers have to take care of a number of this, these 10 nodal centers will be supported to a heavier extent than the remote centers. And since the outlay on each nodal centers will be significantly larger than the 2.5-3 lakhs which are mentioned for each remote centers, the sponsors of the project, that is MHRD, has indicated to us that at least to begin with, all these nodal centers will have to be either government institutions or fully funded institutions which are fully funded by the government of India. Okay. So, it is expected that initially the nodal centers will be institutes like maybe some other IITs or some NITs or, for example, a fully funded government institution like the one in Besu at Sippur or Walchan College of Engineering at Sangli. These are old institutions which are not government institutions. People there are not employees of government of India or any state government, but they are fully funded educational institutions. Okay. I think this should answer a large number of questions by which were being asked by the remote centers. Now, I see a large number of hands raised. I will just take one or two centers before we break for tea. 1060 EBET, Tirupur, over to you.
This is Professor Rashik from EBET. We have the doubt regarding the projects, and could you explain, already you have told that you will be uploading the details in the Moodle, and is there any restriction that the project should not be in the same topic, all those things?
I think I have already said that the project had something to do with Aakash or the applications of Aakash. At present, I can say only that much. More details will be made available by Professor Fatak, who will post the instructions on Moodle within one day, by tomorrow. 1264 Shulini University, Solan.
We want to know the technical specification of this Aakash tablet, as we feel that it is very battery, the limit, battery is very limited here in the Aakash tablet. So, we want to do some improvement over battery consumption. We can optimize through software also, but we need to know the technical specification of batteries used in Aakash tablet. So, how can we get this technical specification of hardware? Over to you, sir.
Thank you for the question. Apparently, there seem to be a number of questions on the battery. I will give you a default answer. I think the tablets which have been distributed to you have never been properly charged. And as all of us know that, I myself have found out that unless a rechargeable battery, whatever kind, goes through a few cycles of full charging, discharging, it doesn't warm up properly for its use. So, what I recommend is, although put this upon Moodle, because I am not saying there is no problem, but I suggest that you charge all the Aakash you have once overnight, then keep them on, let people play with it till it get discharged, again charge it, let it go through 2-3 such cycles, and even then if the problem persists, again talk to the people here, put the query upon Moodle. The moment we see that there are large number of queries on Moodle regarding a particular issue of Aakash, that will be taken up with the appropriate urgency that is needed. Over to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. One another question from my colleague Mr. Ajit Nath, please.
Okay, sir, my question is, can we reinstall the operating system on this Aakash tablet? Over to you, sir.
I'm passing it on to Mr. Kushalkar.
No, right now the image which is available is preloaded from the company. We have not received any images on which through which you can reinstall the software again. Over to you.
So some tablets, they have the operating system is corrupt, and on some others Wi-Fi is not working.
See, I have receiving lot of complaints regarding Wi-Fi on the tablets not getting on. So I request all the RCAs who have received such kind of tablets, please note down the serial number put it on Moodle, so that we can come to know how many tablets are having Wi-Fi related issues and how many few of them have been damaged also. So out of 20, if whatever you have received, 4 are having some Wi-Fi issue. So just please note down the serial numbers and send it to us. Thank you.
SK in Simhagad College, 1260. Simhagad College, Pandharpur. Over to you.
Haan, sir. Congratulations, sir, for the this big event, as well as adding some nice aids in the technical field for the education purpose. Sir, my question is, can we access the another tablet's desktop, another tablet, through the tablet?
You want to access desktop of another PC or laptop on your tablet?
Yes, sir.
So there are few applications which are available on Google Play, like remote desktops and all these things. You can just download and play with it. That's all. Thank you.
Okay. So can we access the another tablets, desktop of tablets, through the tablet, so that we can monitor what the students are doing? If in the lab, if you distribute the tablet through the student, and if they are doing some application related to C language, I want to monitor it. So is it possible to do that?
Tablet to tablet is not possible. Means you want to just capture the screen and view what exactly the students are doing. So no, because whatever is thrown on your screen is visible on other PCs or anything in the tablet using the VNC. But it's only the tablet what is displayed that can be only viewed. There is a software called VNC which can help you for this thing.
1210 Gokte Institute of Technology, Karnataka. Over to you.
We are delighted to be here. And I would like to ask a question that when a clicker quiz is conducted on our local server, we are only getting the number of responses that we have. We are not. Can we get the total details of how each person has individually answered?
Yes. See, the moment you the tablets are the timeout is finished, the respective tablet shows the respective people's answer on the tablets itself. Over to you.
Hello, on our individual tablets we get the answers, but on our local server, can I get to know how many have answered correctly, how many have answered wrongly, the individual details?
Sorry, we are going to modify that part. We have got it, and each remote centers are going to get the local response overall, plus the individual tablets also they can see. That we are going to modify it.
1236 Excel Engineering College, Komarapalayam, Tamil Nadu. Over to you.
Sir, we really appreciate the efforts taken by IIT Bombay in conducting this August project. We are very thankful, sir. Sir, I would like to ask that what are the short-term and long-term objectives of this Aakash project?
The short-term and medium-term objectives are to improve academic interaction between students and faculty so that feedback can be given quickly. And since the students have a small computing device in their hand, for example, it can be used, well, a very rudimentary use will be to use it as a calculator. But it can also do certain type of complex calculations using, for example, Scilab. You can do small amount of programming. For example, at least for the first half a semester, if not the whole semester, for a basic programming course, I think Aakash will be useful, because in such a course, you write programs and subprograms which are maybe 30, 40, 50 lines in length. And I think Aakash compilers, the C and C++ compilers and the Python compilers on Aakash are good enough for this purpose. Okay. If you want to do some reasonably complicated but not too long and too heavy a programming effort, computational programming effort, draw some simple graphs, use Scilab, that's available. A teacher can use it, the clicker part of it, for obtaining immediate feedback, so that mid-course correction, even halfway through a 1 hour or a 1.5 hour lecture, can be implemented. Now, this is short term and medium term, maybe a few years. Remember that any laptop, we know that any electronic machinery, a desktop, laptop, etc., a useful life is 3 to 5 years. And the technology life may only be slightly longer than that. So, I think we should not set up any long term objective for Aakash. The long term objective would be, or even the medium term to long term objective should be, replace Aakash 2 by a much more friendly, much more capable, but not much more costly Aakash 3. Remember that the third, fourth and fifth parts of the acronym may change, but the first two letters LC meaning low cost will remain. What is low cost? That is relative. What is low cost today may not be considered low cost tomorrow and so on, but relatively low cost, that adjective will remain, and that should be one of our constraints if we want hundreds of thousands of Aakash like devices to be used by students. 1008 DKTES Ichalkaranji, over to you.
Good afternoon, sir. Myself L.S. Admuthe from DKT Ichalkaranji. My question is, sir, can we use or can we download IIT applications which has designed by IIT students, that is Scilab or Clicker, on tab which are available in the market? Because I heard that it is designed with the help of Linux and Android OS.
So you can definitely download and install the Clicker APKs which are there on the other tablets that you can buy. But regarding the Linux installation was purely made for the Aakash tablet right now. Because different tablets have got different processors in it and they have to compile based on that.
1248 Sri Sant Gadge Baba College of Engineering and Technology, Bhusawal. Over to you.
Sir, my question is, sir, can you provide your design of Aakash tablet so that we can work on designing, adding more functionality to it by using the extension mechanism of UML? Over to you, sir.
I think what you mean by design of the Aakash tablet, do you mean the hardware of the Aakash tablet?
No, sir. The class diagram, object diagram, class diagram that you are designed for your tablet, so that we can add by using extension mechanism like UML.
Yeah, the present Aakash tablet what you have received is designed around Allwinner A13 processor. You can search on internet for this particular processor, and you can download the data sheet and get the block diagrams and much information on this particular tablet. Thank you. Over to you.
While using the Clicker software, can we display some AutoCAD files or list programming that we using in AutoCAD?
Yeah, we are asking ki while showing the click, displaying the quizzes, and you want to show some image or AutoCAD file on it.
By displaying the AutoCAD programming. That the least programming software which we use in AutoCAD, or you can say the AutoCAD drawings in Clicker software, sir, not for quiz.
See, the Clicker application is specially meant for the quiz, conducting a quiz. For viewing a AutoCAD drawing or DWG drawing or any other thing, there are players available to view these drawings on Android. That particular application has to be downloaded and you can view the things. You can't modify the DWG drawings on Androids.
1121 SVP Engineering College, Vishakhapatnam. Over to you.
My name is Kala. I'm from Civil Department. I'm the coordinator in the department. Sir, I just have a question regarding the topics which you selected for the assignment for 2 weeks. The thing is, what made you to be so aware and so elective towards electronics and computer science, and how do you apply in other departments? You didn't mention, or you didn't even any spectacular things regarding the innovative ideas what you have been collected for the assignment.
See, currently Aakash is a very new tablet. We are learning how to use it. We have put up some software on it, which, well, although we feel is reasonably general purpose, I agree that it is sort of weighed towards CS and things like that. So we have compilers for C++, simple compilers. But for example, you could create small Scilab scripts for civil engineering, okay, which can be used on Aakash. Some simple Scilab script for maybe, well, I am from mechanical engineering, but I know something about deflection of beams, shear diagrams, bending moment diagrams. These you can calculate and show the diagrams on Scilab, and then you change the loading or change the support slightly, and how do those diagrams change, and how does the deflection and maximum stress changes, that you can show. That would be a very, very nice interactive package for civil engineers in your, say, strength of materials or engineering mechanics. That just one thing which comes to my mind. And you could do something similar in hydraulics, fluid mechanics, groundwater flows and things like that. You know, for example, you take a simple textbook, you have a problem. I don't know which part of civil engineering you belong to, but suppose there is a pipeline network and you have some sizes of pipes, lengths and connectors, and you have from a lake to some drain, some flow. And now we give a problem in which maybe one set of parameters is given, and because we expect students to work it out, we don't ask supplementaries as what if. For example, if this pipe, which is maybe some 750 mm diameter, if it is converted to a 900 mm diameter, what will happen? Okay, then plot it as a function of length of a pipe, or some turn which is a bend instead of a very sharp one, you make it shallower, what will happen? Such quick things you can do by writing appropriate Scilab programs. Okay. I suppose such simple things can be done in many other engineering disciplines also. Over to you.
It's a very dignified note from you, sir. We are very grateful for you that. And the one more thing is, the submission of assignment can be done in both the documentary way as well as in a PPT way, the knowledge up to our mark. We can do it like that also.
Instructions will follow, but I get a feeling that if you submit your assignment in a PDF format, that would definitely be acceptable. Now, whether a doc or a PPT, etc., would be acceptable or not, that I would request Professor Fatak to announce on the Moodle within a day. Okay. But I can announce now that PDF, whether slides or document, will definitely be accepted. Over.
You mentioned, like, for a team, three members will be included. Individually, we have to submit all the questions what you mentioned, and individually have to, no need.
The team size
we can electively do it and we can submit for you.
Yes, the team size is between 3 and 5. It's not restricted to 3, and there is only one submission per team. Over.
Okay. So any topic elective is ours only.
Yes, selection of topic is left.
We can
to
elect
you.
Our own topic and we can submit.
Yes.
Okay. It's a nice meeting and talking to you, sir. Thanks a lot. Happy Diwali.
Happy Diwali to you, all of you. Over and out. 1120 St. Aloy CS Institute of Technology, Jabalpur.
Good evening, sir. First of all, we would like to congratulate IIT Bombay for conduction of such a nice workshop and launching of Aakash 2 today by President of India. We would like to ask one question. That we have tried to configure our network on static IP, but we couldn't do that. So presently we are running on dynamic IP, and again we have to change the IP on the Aakash tablet. So could you please suggest us some changes that we can make so that we can configure our network on static IP?
Thank you for your congratulatory message. I will pass on the question to Mr. Rajesh Kushalkar about your IP query.
See, regarding tablets getting dynamic IP, I don't think so there will be issue for the clicker softwares to run. If your server is on dynamic IP and that is changing now and then that's a issue while giving the responses. So you can put on your server, put as a static IP, and whichever access point or DHCP server which you are using it, please map the MAC address to define this particular IP address, to assign this particular IP address only for that particular server. Over to you.
Okay, sir. We'll try. We have one more question, sir. Sir, can we use PHP to develop applications in Aakash?
See, there are a lot of tools available for the Android development. There is a SDK available which is freely downloaded from net. And you can integrate many other programming languages with it to make an application. There are a lot of tutorials already available on YouTube to how to create a very small applications on Androids. You can just check it on the YouTube also. Over to you.
When this Aakash is available in open market, sir?
I'm told that if not exactly Aakash, but tablets very similar to Aakash are available already on the open market. But since that's a commercial proposition, even if I really don't know what that is, but since that's a commercial effort, I will not say what it is or where it is available. This is, I'm not going to take a commercial break for that. Okay. But if you go on to the net or to your local suppliers, you will be able to find tablets with almost exactly similar capabilities as Aakash. Over. 1257 HCTM Technical Campus, Kaithal, Haryana. Over to you, sir.
Sir, it is Professor P.K. Suri, Chairman CSEIT and MCA departments. Sir, it's wonderful. I must congratulate you for your wonderful organized this workshop for 2 days. And we all are very much enthusiastic for learning few more things. I hope, are you going to organize any conference or workshop on simulation sort of applications? And another question is that if we wish to install some of the language processor for simulation languages, which OS would be appropriate? Whether it would be Android or Aakash or Ubuntu or which one you feel that it will be appropriate?
Your question is on simulation, and neither myself, neither Mr. Kushalkar, I suppose, is an expert in that. If you put up, if you request your people to put this up on Moodle, the team here would tell you what is to be done. But remember that Aakash is a low cost and hence not great capacity tablet. So if you want to do some basic development and try out large number of quick options, then perhaps Android is not a, it's not a platform on which you develop something. It's a platform on which after having developed something, you implement that for the final execution. That much I can tell you now, but for more technical thing, please put up the query on Moodle and it will get answered. Thank you. Over to you.
R&D sharing, that was the basic idea for that. Right, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, first of all, I would like to thank to all the Aakash team for this successful completion of the 2-day IST workshop on Aakash for Education, sir. In this, sir, in all the remote center, there is a technical staff is also working from the last one month, sir. They hard work day and night, sir. Sir, is there any provision for Aakash staff for those people, sir? Because they are as practical as we are, sir. Over to you, sir.
I am told it's restricted only to faculty at this moment. Over.
Successful completion of the workshop in all the remote centers, sir.
I can't tell you anything more than what I have already said. If you want the request, you can put in a specific request, it will get handled in an appropriate manner, which may not be any different than what I have told you now.
Thank you very much. It is my feedback, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Wish you a very happy Diwali. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. Your feedback is noted. Over and out. 1123 Thakral College of Technology, Bhopal. Over to you. 1054 National College of Engineering, Tirunelveli.
Good evening, sir, and very happy to be a part of this Aakash project. Myself is Narayanan Prashant, the Remote Center Coordinator of National College of Engineering, 1054. Regarding the NKN, during the testing process, I found your technical team member has asked whether you are connected through internet or NKN. Can you give some information regarding the NKN and whether we can use NKN as a substitute for internet?
Well, the internet, I don't know much detail, so put up a query on Moodle, because then everybody will know the correct answer from the proper person. But I am told that the normal internet is one channel, NKN is a parallel channel, and NKN is a national knowledge network. So the normal internet is connected not only to the educational institutes, but even to research organizations, commercial establishments, homes of people, everywhere. It is an internet of everything, whereas NKN, I am told, is essentially educational network. So it is restricted only to educational institute. We will not have somebody trying to sell toothpaste on that network. Over to you.
Because when I found the list in the net regarding NKN, the colleges, most of the colleges are government organizations and universities. As we are in private institution, whether it is possible to get NKN?
Well, I don't really know what are the policies of NKN, but put this query up on Moodle and Professor Fatak will reply. 1044 Sasuri, Tirupur, over to you.
The tablet which you have given does not contain any antivirus software. Does it require to have any antivirus software, or we can download a free open source antivirus and install it in our tablet?
See, as far as the Android is concerned, there are not much virus available on it. But still, if you feel any threat of it of any kind, you can try it, but I suggest not to do that part. Over to you.
Can we use this Aakash for as a controlling device in our mechanical department for controlling the boilers, pressures, etc., and also in our CAM machines?
Right now, whatever the control part, what we have demonstrated was a robo control. So anything which can be driven electrically, on which an electronic interface can be made, can be controlled. But nothing mechanical movements which require manpower or anything can be done.
Good evening, sir. I am Dr. Salvapunda, Aakash coordinator. First of all, we are very much thankful and grateful for our participation in this Aakash project. So we need some clarifications. Sir already told in the previous session that we have to note down the serial numbers of the tablets which are having minor defects, like not getting into Wi-Fi, etc. So the next process is whether we have to resend those tablets to the IIT Mumbai, or do you have any future plan related to troubleshooting in their respective colleges? Over to you, sir.
Yes, that's a proper question. We have received such complaints from a number of centers. Within a day or so, you will get instructions regarding the current status, how to fill up the current status of each of the tablet which you have and which you will receive in future on an appropriate web page, so that we have the complete status and the various issues associated with it. Okay? Once that database gets reasonably populated, we will decide what to do and instructions will follow. Just now, keep the tablets with you in your custody. Don't be in a hurry to send them back to IIT Bombay or to whichever place you receive. Just now keep them in your custody. let's see to it that the first lot of tablets is distributed, then we will take an overall view and then a policy statement will follow about what is to be done. Over. 1117 SVITS Indore.
Sir, myself Rajesh Kumar Chakravarti. I am working as a remote center coordinator and Aakash coordinator this time. Sir, actually we are having 95 plus participants at our remote center. The participants are very happy to attend the workshop and they have a query in their mind that whether you are considering this time some non-engineering people for attending the this workshop. So can you include some non-technical applications? For example, you can include some non-technical application examples for their help to attend the workshop properly.
See, originally it was planned for only engineering faculty. But let us say now, because of the ground situation, let us say faculty in engineering colleges. We won't call it engineering faculty, we will say faculty in engineering colleges, those are included. So any project which is an appropriate project in an engineering institute is acceptable. So maybe driven by a faculty member in say physics, economics, so long as it's in an engineering institution and the remote center coordinator belongs to the engineering institution, that's okay. Over to you.
Can we integrate camera available in the Aakash tablet with Scilab?
This is about camera integration with Scilab. About the camera in Aakash, we have a question mark. Our specification of Aakash does not include a camera. The camera happens to be there because, see, we made out a specification and the supplier found out that the supplier has a tablet which meets our specification but has an extra camera. Now, since it's very difficult for the supplier at short notice to remove the camera and manufacture so many pieces, I think the supplier has provided us at least the first 20,000 pieces with a camera. We are not sure the remaining pieces will be with the camera. So just now we are not looking at any process by which we will integrate the camera with the software. Just now we will keep quiet about it. Over. 1074 Carmel Engineering, Pathanam Thitta.
Sir, we have received the 20 tablets and within that, those 20 tablets, the C, C++ and Scilab was not there. And we have installed the C4 droid that will execute C and C++ programs. But unfortunately, we haven't got the Scilab. And we have searched in internet as well as that Scilab.in, that APK for Scilab is not available in that website. So kindly provide that website or URL for getting Scilab APK to install within our tablets. Sir, over to you, sir.
In today's morning session, we have explained you the installation of APL, Aakash programming languages, in which C, C++, Python and Scilab was included. So that file, the link is provided on the Moodle. You can just go through the link and download the files from the GitHub, and there is an instruction of how to install this software on the tablet using a Ubuntu PC. So you have to run the scripts and connect your tablet to the laptop or PC via USB cable and run the script, and the software will be installed on your tablet. Over to you.
Shall we get that Scilab as a single software package?
Scilab as a single software or as a APK is not available.
Okay, it is showing that Scilab 5.1 is loading. At that time, we expected that we will get that also.
No, because the APL which yesterday sir has also explained, it's a one more basic Linux version on top of Android has been created, a virtual VM, I can tell you. is created on top of Android. So in that, all this C, C++, Python and Scilabs are running. So there is no particular APK for Scilab is right now available. Over to you.
Sir, and with the our electrical faculty members and electronics faculty members are asking that the robotics control on application is loaded in our tablet. And will it be able to control the robots in at our remote center also? I heard that the Kavi area has on project on that robot controlling applications, and she is working on that. We have made a query for getting these robots to our college. Unfortunately, we won't get it. And future, we are expecting that with these tablets, for our electronics department can do more with that. Is there any help we'll get from your side on that? Over to you, sir.
See, as far as I know regarding the dispatching of robots and all this thing, it's from the Kavi area, sir, is they are on the way, and they are basically they are more tied up with the e-yantra workshop, what they are going to do it right now. So after that, they will be dispatching to the colleges. I'm not sure about it. You can put this question on the Moodle and get the appropriate answers.
1013, Mepko Schlenk Sivakati. Over to you.
I am Dr. T. Revati, Aakash coordinator, sir. Our faculty members attended the quiz, sir, using 20 tablets. They answered all the 4 questions, but they didn't get the score. Is it due to timeout problem or some other problem, sir?
After the quiz has been over, that individual tablets will get the answer immediately on the tablets. So whatever the tablets have been assigned to the people, they will get the immediate feedback on the tablets itself.
It is meant that 2 days ISTE workshop. What is the role of ISTE in this workshop?
This will be answered by Dr. Mukta Atre.
Good evening. We have a collaboration with the Indian Society for Technical Education, and apparently it helps the teaching faculty if they attend a workshop conducted by ISTE, it helps in their promotion. That is why we have tied up with ISTE. Does that answer your question? Over.
Sir, I am Arivadhan, head of the institution of Mepko Schlenk Engineering College. I would like to ask one question. Will you be able to supply mass number of tablets for the entire community of our student in our campus? Even at a rate, subsidized rate.
I can't really answer that question because this project is not for subsidized sale of tablets. There may be another channel which has nothing to do with the Aakash 2 project. Maybe the subsidized tablets are almost exactly like Aakash 2, or maybe they are Aakash 2 themselves. But this is a project where Aakash 2 is going to be put through its paces with about 1 lakh people using it all over the place. Okay. This is a proving project for Aakash 2. And hence, only after this, maybe that second part, unrelated to this, direct sale with subsidy or whatever will take place. But this project will not have anything to do with it. These Aakash tablets will, as I said in the morning, are owned by IIT Bombay on behalf of the government of India. Whatever are being distributed to you and to others, those are in your custody. You are the custodian. And hence, they are not just to be given to a faculty member, they have the same status as a good costly book in your library. It is issued out, and at the end of its use, at an appropriate time, which is pre-decided, it is to be returned. And I said that we want complete traceability of every tablet has a number, and at the click of a button or within a few minutes or hours, one should be able to trace through the remote center coordinator where that tablet is. I think it's almost coming to 5:30. So thank you very much.